Hello, everyone out there in TV land. Thanks for joining us tonight, watching a wrestling match. Sorry for the technical difficulty here with the audio. We just finished our first match at 220 pounds, where Tyler Hoover pinned Joe Howard from Rochester, putting North Miami up after one match, 6-0. Currently on the mat right now at heavyweight, we have Randall Brock versus Evan Beach. Beach gets a takedown. He's up 2-0.
Look, we put that weight on that elbow. Suck him in. You gotta suck him in. No regret. They gotta get that other
arm out. Beach lets him up. They're back to neutral. Score is now 2-1. North Miami snaps him down to the mat and circles for the 2-point takedown. We got a pin in a minute and 47 seconds for North Miami. North Miami gets 6 points for the team, now putting them up 12-0, going into the 106-pound weight class. For Rochester at 106 is Josh Heckathorn, wrestling Gibson from North Miami. Wrestlers are still working their ties to try to gain position to shoot for a takedown. There was an attempt by Josh. Wasn't successful. Josh is in deep on a single, switches to a double. He's got him on his butt. 2 takedown. Wrestlers go out of bounds. Back to the center. Josh stops his first move. He's controlling his hips, keeping him broken down. End of the first period. Josh is up 2-0. Rochester has choice for the second period, deferring his choice to the third. North Miami will choose. North Miami takes some injury time. It looks like he may have jammed a finger. Thank you. Injury time has stopped, and now North Miami decides to go neutral to start the second period. Got a stalling call on red. As it's being called, Josh gets in on a single leg, and they scramble out of bounds, and he gets the takedown as they go out of bounds. Josh is now up 4-0. Seconds to go in the period, and Josh is in a good position to possibly get some back points. Here he's got the back points, looking for the fall. Referee's counting near fall. Five seconds left in the period. And the period ends. Josh gets a three near fall. A three near fall consists of the referee counting to five while the opponent's back is exposed at a 45-degree angle or more towards the mat. If a referee gets two count, he will award a two near fall. We go into the third period with Rochester up 7-0, and Rochester chooses top. Josh quickly gets the North Miami opponent to his back. Referee's counting, and he gets the pinfall. With a minute 42 left in the third period, Rochester closes the gap to 12-6. And as you may know, or if you don't know, you can score different points for your team by winning a match. If you win by 1-7 points, it's a decision and you get 3 points for your team. If you win 8-14, you score 4 points for your team. If you get 15-point lead or better against an opponent, they stop the match and call it a technical foul, and you score 5 points. Other points, if you get a pinfall, you get 6 for your team. So there's a little bit of strategy in where if you have a 7-point lead, you may want to try to get that extra point before the match ends to get a bonus point for your team. Schroeder pushes the legs in and breaks his opponent down to the mat, looking for a power half. Bit of info on the last match, Josh Heckathorn, a freshman for Rochester at 106, is now 7-0 on the season.
Up and out. couple times.
And that's how we end the first period. Rochester up 2-0. Choice in the second period goes to, I believe, North Miami. Referee is checking at the table to make sure. North Miami defers to the third period. Rochester chooses down. North Miami got a stalling warning. When an opponent stands up off the mat and you're just hanging on a leg, not trying to attempt to take him back to down to the mat, you will get called for stalling. Rochester gets a stall or a reversal call out of that, which is worth 2 points. Rochester is now up 4-0. Out of bounds, back to the center. North Miami will start in a down position. Oh, North Miami has stop for blood. Clean up for the North Miami wrestler. An opponent, if they have a stoppage for blood, there's a clock that starts. You have 5 minutes, and it can stop and start as many times as you like during the match. But if you run, if you're still bleeding after 5 minutes of blood time, you will have to forfeit the match. In this case, Meixel did not have to have blood time started. He just had cleanup. What happened there was the wrestlers were into a position where neither wrestler could advance their position, so they called a stalemate and they start over. Schroeder's got a cradle locked up but in dangerous position of being reversed and put to his back, but he gets back out of it. Now he's back into control. Locks up another cradle. He's getting back points. Possibly a fall here. He lets that move released, and he gets a 3-near fall. We're now up 7-0. Time, second period. 2 minutes to go in the third period. Rochester's up 7-0 in this match. Again, this is where I discussed earlier about earning extra team points. Right now we're up 7-0, and Schroeder would earn 3 points for a victory. But if he were to score one more point, he could score an extra bonus point for the team, or four. But we've got 2 minutes of wrestling left, so a lot can happen. Take down Rochester. Now we're up 9-0. Now we work for more bonus points. After three matches, North Miami leads Rochester 12-6. Justin's doing a nice job controlling his opponent, not allowing him to escape from the bottom or get a reversal. He's got him in position for some near fall. Referee's counting. And he gets the fall with 54 seconds left in the third period. That gives Rochester 6 team points, and that ties the dual team score at 12-12 after four matches. Going into the 120-pound weight class, we have freshman Seth Moon versus North Miami's Alan Mock. Wrestlers go to the edge of the mat, go out of bounds. Nobody's in control, so we're still neutral. Mock gets in on a takedown, is up 2-0. Score after the first period is 2-0, Mock of North Miami over Moon of Rochester. Mock apparently had a minor nosebleed and is cleaning it up right now. A little confusion on the Rochester coaching side of wondering why blood time hasn't been started. Mock is one of North Miami's more experienced wrestlers on their varsity squad, and Seth is a freshman with a lot of potential. Rochester chose to defer their choice to the third period. Mock choosing down is working on a reversal here. He's about to get it. Referee gives two reversal and calls time for potentially dangerous having his arm caught. So they go back to the center and start over. North Miami is now up 4-0. Scrambling out of bounds. Both wrestlers are working hard to try to advance their position.
Go, Turk!
Mock exposed Moon's back for a quick one count, but Moon was able to get back to his belly for no near fall. Second period ends with North Miami leading 4-0. Rochester's choice in the third. Rochester chooses to go neutral. Did not have much success in 4 minutes of trying to get away, so we try to take him down off of our feet. Well, we got in on a shot. Mock falls to his hip, but quickly gets back up to his feet. Shot Mock, North Miami is in deep, turns the corner, sits him to his butt and gets the 2 points. Mock lets him up for an escape. Score is now 6-1. Wrestlers come back to the middle and we're neutral. That's a shot, reshot, good reshot by Mock. Scores another takedown. Attempted to cut Moon, but Moon reaches in for his leg, working on possible reversal here. Mock is still in control in this position or situation. Now he gets an escape. Score is now 8-2 with 45 seconds to go. Bonus team points are big in a duel like this. So Mock is working for a major decision, which is win by 8 points. And Moon is still trying to win the match, but at the same time trying to keep it close. We now have a takedown. It is 10-2. Mock is up 8 points with 20 seconds to go. An escape would be big for Rochester here. Mock's got a leg in, riding tough. 4 seconds. And there's your final. 10-2. Alan Mock over Seth Moon of Rochester. He gets 4 points for his team. That puts North Miami up 16-12 after 5 matches. Next up at 126 is sophomore John Hunting from Rochester and Warren Russo from North Miami. Snap shot by John Hunting, trying to circle to get control. North Miami wrestler's got his arms around his leg, preventing him to circle behind to get his 2 points. There, he's got his leg free, and he scores 2. Breaks his opponent down, and now is going to work for a turn. Thank you. We got a turn. And we get a quick fall from John Hunting in a minute and 20 seconds of the first period. After six matches, that puts Rochester up 18-16. There are 14 weight classes in a team duel. And as you see, Jay Heckathorn, a sophomore from Rochester, just received a forfeit at 132. A forfeit scores exactly the same as a pinfall. So he scored 6 points for his team. Rochester goes up 24-16. At 138, Ben Horbin, a junior for Rochester, also will receive a forfeit, putting Rochester up 30-16. Six matches to go. Rochester's up 30-16 in this duel. We have now up at 145 pounds, freshman Michael Whitfield versus Levi McKee of North Miami. Rochester currently has 27 wrestlers on its wrestling team, and not one of them are a senior. So Rochester is a very young team at this time. We got a takedown by North Miami. Puts North Miami up 2-0. Stalemate called by a referee. Tonight's referee is Robert Bryant of Rochester. Robert's been a refereeing football and wrestling for quite some time. McKee of North Miami has a half Nelson in. Oh, and he throws a full Nelson in, which is illegal, giving Rochester a one-point penalty. So referee stops the action, puts them back to the center of the mat, and they start over. He's running a pretty hard spiral ride, trying to keep Whitfield down on the mat. Did not get a two count by the referee. He did get a one count with the roll through. Rochester was able to roll on through for a no near fall. And after the first period, North Miami leads 2-1. Rochester's choice, and Rochester defers to the third period. North Miami chooses to go down. McKee quickly to his feet, does a standing switch, and gets his reversal. Reversal is worth 2 points, and he is now up 4-1. We got an illegal hold. That's a second penalty on the North Miami wrestler, giving Rochester 2 points in the match. The next penalty, if North Miami were to get another penalty, would be worth 2 points to the Rochester wrestler. And if he were to do a fourth penalty, he is automatically disqualified of the match. Rochester would win, giving them 6 points for the team, equaling a fall in the match. Got a scramble. It looks like North Miami's going to get some near fall. If not the fall, and he does get the fall. We've got 51 seconds into the second period. North Miami gets a fall. The score is now Rochester 30, North Miami 22 after nine matches. Going into the 10th match in 152 pounds, Tyler Downauer, junior from Rochester, is wrestling Paul Meixel of North Miami. Micah at 145 was wrestling his first varsity match of the season. Had a bit of tough luck there, but did okay in the first couple periods there. It's a good learning lesson for him. Wrestlers are fighting for position to take one another down. No one seems to have got there. Got the upper hand yet. Tyler had a series of fakes, didn't work out, but they both scrambled back to their feet. And they go out of bounds, back to the center. Got a nice single leg in on the edge of the mat. Mike Soul's defending it well. We get a stalemate call. Back to neutral into the center of the mat. Neither wrestler is having any luck getting a takedown here in the first period. We have 10 seconds to go. Shot Rochester is in deep. And time expires. No takedown. Score is 0-0 after the first period. North Miami defers to the third period. Rochester chooses down. In a close match like this, stamina could become a very important factor. Early in the season, correct that, any time of the season, when you got a lot of action going on at like this, one wrestler may be in better shape than the other, may not be the better wrestler, but could lose a match because they're just not in as much shape as the other guy. This could be a factor in this match. We'll have to see. Another stalemate call. Tyler getting a little bit of instruction from Coach Guard. Tyler's to his feet, spins. Appears to about to have the one. Referee gives him an escape. Rochester's up 1-0. Back to our feet. North Miami with a good shot. He's in pretty deep. Tyler's trying to sprawl out. Hips are down. Now he's trying to drive into him.
Back up! Back up!
Wrestlers are scrambling for a takedown. Out of trouble. End of the second period. Rochester leads 1-0. North Miami's choice. North Miami chooses down. Granby roll to a reversal. That puts North Miami up 2-1. Rochester goes down. Rochester quickly to their feet, tries to face the wrestler. Oh, he gets a throw. We got one escape. If they were inbounds, that would have been a two reversal, and he would have been getting near fall at that time. But instead, we get one escape. Now we work for a takedown. The score is 2-2 with 1:40 to go. Shot Rochester on the edge of the mat. They go out of bounds. Again, being in shape is where it's gonna, what it's going to come down to in this match. Which wrestler wants it more? Shot Rochester. He's in deep on a single. He's trying to turn the corner. Oh, sits him on his hip and gets the two takedown. Rochester's up 4-2. One minute left in the third period. We got a stalling warning for North Miami. And a quick note, stalling is when a wrestler is not trying to improve their position or allowing a top wrestler or another wrestler to improve their position. And you get one warning in a match, and the second one you give up one penalty point. And again, you give up another point if you get called for the third time, and 2 points for the fourth time, and disqualification for the fifth. There we go. We got a second warning call on the North Miami wrestler, giving Rochester a 5-2 lead. 11.9 seconds left in this match. Rochester's leading 5-2. Again, a 1-7 point victory. Will give your team 3 points. 8-14 point victory will give your team a major decision or 14 points. And 15 or more will give you a tech fall or 5 points for your team. 5-2, your victor is Tyler Downauer from Rochester. Puts Rochester at 33 points for their team against North Miami's 22. 160 pounds, we have Braxton Lee from Rochester, a junior, wrestling Patrick Doyle from North Miami. Correct that. Braxton Lee gets a forfeit at 160, putting Rochester up 39-22 with 3 weight classes to go.
Nice, Braxton!
Didn't do anything.
Good job, Braxton!
Woo!
Up next is, at 170 pounds, is Adam Bashan, sophomore for Rochester, versus Tony Hubert.
Good job, Braxton!
With Braxton's forfeit, that improves him to 5-1 on the season. I'm sorry, 6-1 on the season. Same for Tyler Downauer. We've got a takedown for North Miami. looking to expose the Rochester wrestler's back. And we get a quick fall in 54 seconds for North Miami. They close the gap from 39 to 28. There's two matches to go. North Miami can still win this duel by a score of 40 to 39 if they pin both Rochester wrestlers. Up next is 182, Michael Leonard, first match back from a collarbone injury that he sustained during football season, is wrestling Jacob Klingeman of North Miami. Michael gets a takedown to go up 2-0. A win by Michael will secure the dual victory over North Miami. Indiana Wrestling, High School Wrestling, has a coaches association, and they rank wrestling teams by their class size, and North Miami is ranked number 5 in the class 1A by the coaches. Michael Leonard's got North Miami wrestler on his back looking for the pin. Had a half Nelson in. He's now readjusting to get chest on chest in 90 degrees. He throws his half in here, gets his elbow to the back of his head. And there's the fall. That pinfall secures the victory for Rochester with one match to go. Rochester has 45 points and North Miami at 28. Up next in our last match of the night at 195 pounds is Jordan Schaefer of Rochester versus Lane Eckroat of North Miami. Wrestlers are trying to get some control. Wrestlers work to the edge of the mat. Snap down. Nice snap down, but on the edge of the mat. Tonight's match is brought to you by Rochester Telephone Company's local channel number 4. Five seconds to go. Nice shot on the edge of the mat. Back to the center. Nice shot. Work out of bounds. Back to the center. 11 seconds to go. Another nice snap down. Time runs out at the end of the period. We go into the second period. Score is tied 0-0. North Miami defers to their choice for the third period. Rochester chooses to go down. Schaefer makes it to his feet, gets to the edge of the mat, circles back to the center. We got a warning stalling North Miami for not taking Schaefer back down to the mat in a proper time. In the same time, Schaefer earns his escape point, goes up 1-0. Wrestlers go out of bounds. Back to the center. 1:20 left in the second period. Seconds left in the second period. Wrestlers are still on their feet looking for a takedown. Two minutes left in the third period. Rochester's leading 1-0. North Miami chooses down. In that scramble, North Miami gets to their feet. Jordan takes him back down to the mat, but out of bounds. They start again back in the bottom position for North Miami, and Rochester is now taking the top position. Jordan breaks the North Miami opponent down to the mat. Oh, he's looking for a tilt. Just a roll through. No count at all from the referee. The referee's signals roll through. Jordan Schaefer's working an armbar and it goes to a crossface. Back to 2-on-1. 2-on-1 is where he has both of his hands on his opponent's wrist, trying to curl it underneath his body to get them flat. End of the third period. Rochester wins a close 1-0 match by decision, giving them a total of 48 points. The duel is now complete. Rochester winning 48-28. On behalf of Rochester Telephone Company, I'm Chad Morgan. And I can personally say from the coaching staff and the wrestlers of Rochester, I'd like to thank everyone who watched the match tonight.